problem is we're not holding this man up. You see,
I know we're not holding the man up. That's why we're here. But don't tell me about the phone because I was there.
But he can't. You're
talking like a fine. I was right out. Come in.
The problem is we got
to get
pressure from this man to hold us up.
But he's not giving him pressure. He didn't at the time he gave him.
Hello, Gail.
What?
Yeah, sit down.
All right.
You know Ed McKenzie, JC.
Well, I'll call you back on it, all right?
Want some iced tea?
Yeah, please.
I'll tell you what we wanted to talk to you about, Gail. You see, I'm an old timer in a lot of ways. At least that's what some people keep telling me. But I don't think it's all that common for a man of my age to come to be used to the way things are, to be comfortable with things. What it comes down to is that JC had a notion here, and Ed seems to think it's a good idea. I guess maybe we are due for some changes around here.
You want me to play flank and not running back?
No. No, it's not that simple, Gail. Now, JC's idea, and yes, I did agree with him, is that this is 1965, and we'd like the Bears to room together according to position without any regard to race. So we'd like you and Brian Piccolo to room together.
That's all? That's what this is about?
Is that all?
Yeah, you had me worried. I thought it was something really.
This is something really. Man, you're talking about a white man and a black man rooming together on a team that's never been done before. And you're going to be called a Tom by some blacks and uppity nigger by some whites. And when we go on the road, man, I'm talking about we going to Atlanta, Houston, Miami, New Orleans. It ain't gonna be no better than Detroit, or Minnesota, or San Francisco, or any other town we play in. You're gonna rock the boat, says. And the people out there that's already seasick.
What JC is saying is that there may be some pressures. Severe ones. Now, what do you say?
Shame you couldn't ask me how I felt about it, isn't it?
Look, you want me out?
Nah. I don't want you out to stay. I guess I'm just
steam at the old man for not putting me in that skirmish this afternoon.
That your wife?
Yeah.
Pretty.
So is yours and the little girl.
Thanks. Supposed to call her tonight. Tell her how I'm going. I guess that might be the shortest phone call in history.
Maybe not. Pick. They wouldn't assign us a room together unless we both made the team.
That's right, isn't it?
Congratulations on making the team, gentlemen. Well done.
You know, Coach Hallis kind of frowns on the hazing of new men.
But now that you've made the team, it's really like you're one of us. Welcome to the Chicago Bears!
You can't stay in the past, George. I mean, it's 1960.
I know what year it is. We don't need any distractions. We don't need any trouble.
How could it hurt us?
Come in. Well, are you just gonna stand there and stare at us, or are you gonna say something, Gail?
You asked to see me.
Damn right I did. Get in here. So, look. We're gonna start a new policy around here. It's gonna start with you. My brain trust tells me that it's time that the bears started rooming together by position. That maybe it's not a good idea anymore that the guys be split up by race. You follow? That maybe if we mix everybody up, we'll get some understanding on this team. And that's a good thing, right? So, you got any problem rooming with a white man?
No.
Do you have any problem rooming with Brian Piccolo?
Well, look, no. No, I guess not.
You better be sure, Gale. It's gonna make a lot of people mad. And it ain't gonna be fun when we play down in Atlanta, Dallas, Houston. You can say no.
No, it's okay with me, if it's okay with him.
Oh, he'll be fine with it. Trust me.
Excuse me, I thought this was my room.
Yeah, well, it's mine now, too.
You gotta be kidding me.
What? They didn't tell you?
Well, we're rooming together? Me and you.
That's right.
What, for tonight, this week?
For the season.
What? Why didn't anybody ask me?
Listen, I'm not happy about being with you either. So if you want to find another roommate, please be my guest.
Man, you must be a racist.
Well, you make a good argument for it.
You are real hilarious all of a sudden, aren't you? Well, it doesn't matter anyhow. An old man's gonna cut me any minute. You saw the kind of day I had out there.
You're not getting cut.
Oh, what, you're psychic now, too? Psychic comedian, is that it?
Why would they have us room together if you didn't make the team?
Well, damn. I always liked you, Sayers.